This abandoned building was once the site of a double homicide. Two men shot and killed here back in 2016. And their families still don't have any answers. Tonight, another plea to find the people who killed Justin Bokma and LeFranc Matthews.
It's been a living hell.
Grieving families want to know who is behind the early morning shooting at what police called an illegal after-hours lounge in the Kensington Market area. Shots rang out in the early hours of Canada Day inside the establishment, also injuring two other men. But police and loved ones still don't know who fired the guns. Nancy Bokma, Justin's mother, has been pleading for answers for 4 years now and says LeFranc's family is equally distraught.
I know they're having such a hard time going through this too, you know, we're all struggling.
LeFranc, who left behind children, and Bokma, a decorated professional skateboarder, were employees at the lounge named Retox. Police say Bokma, who had been working as a doorman, intervened in an altercation that broke out on the second floor shortly after 5 a.m.
So I thought, let's give it one more try. Let's see if somebody can do the moral thing, you know. Somebody has to have a heart.
We've had very little cooperation or participation in the investigation from people who were actually here.
Back in 2018, police offered a $50,000 reward in the unsolved murders, confident that the suspects had been inside the lounge earlier in the night.
They've been at this club before. They were there to deal drugs. There were at least 40 to 50 people that I'm confident were inside the premises. Immediately after the shooting, everyone, which is natural, scattered out of the building.
Police said witnesses provided descriptions for the three suspects. The first, a black male, 5'9", with a skinny build, was in his mid to late 20s and back in 2016 had hair in thin braids to his shoulders. The second, a black male who went by the street name Mo, described as 5'6", with a short and skinny build. He had crooked teeth, was in his 30s, and his right arm was smaller and skinnier than average. The last suspect, the black male, 5'9", with medium build, clean-shaven on that night, and was in his early 20s to early 30s.
There's ongoing struggles with any investigation. One is the safety concerns and people being afraid of coming forward to providing information.
Police hope as time passes, people who were there that night or have any information will come forward and bring some peace to the families.
I really don't care the fact that you were in an after-hours club. What I'm looking for is information that can lead us to the identification of the suspects involved in the murders.
If you have any information, there are a number of ways that you can reach out to detectives. First, anonymously by calling Crime Stoppers at 416-222-TIPS, or you can leave a message on their social media apps, or you can call detectives at 416-808-7400. At College in Augusta, I'm Faiza Amin for City News.